Core inflation reflects the change in the prices of goods and services in all sectors except food and energy. These two sectors are excluded from calculating core inflation as they are highly volatile. Any change in these sectors can throw off the entire measure of inflation depicting the underlying trends. Now, like most other measures of inflation, core inflation is also calculated using Consumer Price Index, or CPI. Essentially, the CPI measures the change in the prices of goods and services. Another measure of inflation is the Core Personal Consumption Expenditures Index, which is measured for the consumer prices in the US. Alternative measures of calculating core inflation involve the outliers method, under which products with the largest price changes are removed. Now, apart from excluding change in the cost of food and energy, core inflation also excludes the impact of government excise duties. Moreover, core inflation is considered an essential guide to long-term inflation, although it can be misleading for consumers due to excluding some important sectors of the economy. Now, back to why core inflation doesn't include food and energy prices. These sectors tend to fluctuate a lot, and both of them comprise essential or staple goods, and therefore any fluctuations in their prices do not immediately reflect in their demand. Consider food items like bread, flour, and fruit, which are key parts of daily consumption and cannot be removed from your consumption basket. Any rise in their prices would be met with a substantial reduction in the demand for other non-essential goods in the consumption basket. Similarly, any increase in gas prices does not deepen the demand for it significantly. While demand might be affected by price changes in these categories to a small extent, it does not always move out of the same level at prices. So now, why is core inflation measured? Well, it's important to gauge just how much the underlying inflation is rising to measure the decline in the standard of living in the region. If income does not rise at the same rate as the rise in prices of goods and services, then inflation can significantly weaken people's buying power. It can multiply over time and show an even stronger impact as the years go by. Rising consumer prices eat away at the value of money and make the cost of living higher and standards poorer. When wages match pace with inflation, consumers do not feel as much of an impact of rising inflation. Although, the alternative can be severely damaging, and it's exactly what's been visible in the post-COVID era. Thus, inflation can also impact the economic productivity of a country, and it can also hurt businesses to the point of a shutdown. Now you're up to speed, give us a sub and hit that bell icon to stay ahead of the game. I'm Holly Shields for Kalkinemedia.